Hey, it's you, bro. I hope you're doing well. And in this video, we're going to be discussing meta tags in HTML. Let's get into it. Meta tags are used for metadata, which is information about data. Think of it as data about data. That's why it's called metadata. We place meta tags within the head of our HTML document. So if you're following along, make sure you place these meta tags within the head of your document and not the body. So metadata has some uses for search engines and web browsers and a few other benefits. Metadata lets these entities and your web browser know what your web page is about and what kind of content it contains. There's other uses of meta tags too that allow us to control the viewport, which is the visible area of a web page when you switch devices, such as if you're viewing a page on a mobile device or a tablet. Meta tags will give the browser instructions on the dimensions of your page when it's displayed on a mobile device, or if it's displayed on a laptop or a desktop. So let's cover a few of the basic meta tags, and we're going to be placing these within the head of our document. We're going to type in a set of angle brackets, and we're just going to type in meta within the angle brackets. And this is a self-closing tag, so you don't need a closing tag after this. The first thing that we're going to cover is an attribute called charset. So we're going to set charset equal to something. And what this charset does is that this will let the web browser know which character set we are using. These would be character sets such as ASCII, ANSI, and Unicode. If we would like to use Unicode, which covers most characters and symbols that exist in pretty much every written language, we can use the charset attribute and set this to Unicode, which is UTF-8. And this covers things such as kanji characters, different symbols. Pretty much you can't go wrong, even if you have like a document in plain English, you can't go wrong with just throwing in a meta tag that has charset set to Unicode. Let's move on from character sets and make another meta tag. Another meta tag attribute is the name attribute. And if we set name to keywords, we can define some keywords about our web page for search engines like Google or Bing to identify. So let's set some keywords. We'll use the content attribute. So we'll say content. And then let's just describe what our web page is about using a few words. So if this, for example, the video you're watching right now is an HTML tutorial on the YouTube page called Brocode, perhaps we'll put some keywords in here such as HTML, we can separate these with a comma, maybe tutorial, bro code, then maybe YouTube. I guess that works. So these are like keyword search terms, think of it like that. And depending on what you place in here, that might help with your rankings for search engines, but they basically describe what your web page is about in just a few words. Let's create another meta tag. And this is going to be similar to what we had previously. We're going to use the name attribute, but this time we're going to set this to description. All right. And then we will use the content attribute. And now we can add a full description about this webpage. And you can type in perhaps like a whole sentence. So for my example, I'll type in bro code HTML tutorial for beginners. That should be good enough. So you can give a description about your web page too, and search engines can actually pick up the stuff and learn what your web page is about then. Let's create another meta tag. And this time we're going to use the name attribute, but this time we're going to set this to author so we can list an author for this web page. So we'll use the content attribute for this, and I'll just make up a name. So bro, and then I'll make up a last name. Washington. So you can set an author for this web page. It's a fairly simple meta tag and a fairly simple attribute. This next one is going to be a little complex. We can set the viewport, which is the visible area of a web page, depending on which device is being used to view the page. If you're using a mobile device such as a tablet or a phone, you want to be sure that the dimensions will fit on your device so that the dimensions and the scaling will adjust to accommodate that specific device. So follow me, this is what we're going to type. So within a meta tag, we're going to set the name equal to viewport, all right? Then we'll use the content attribute And then within here, this is what we're going to type. Width equals device dash width comma initial dash scale equals 1 or 1.0. All right. So what this does is that these are instructions for the web browser to change the scaling and dimensions to appear to match the device you are using to view that web page, and the initial scale is set to 1 or 1.0 that will set the zoom level when the page is first loaded. So if you would like your web page to be more easily readable on mobile devices, you'll want to be sure to include this meta tag. All right, I have one more for you guys. You can also set a meta tag that will refresh your web page automatically after so many seconds. This is what we're going to do that. We'll use a meta tag, and within here, we're going to type http-equiv. All right, and we're going to set this equal to refresh. Next, we're going to set the content equal to how many seconds that we want our web page to refresh. I'm going to pick something ridiculous like 3. Like, I want this web page to refresh every 3 seconds. I wouldn't normally recommend this, but it's going to work for our demonstration. So I'm going to save this and reload the page. But, you know, we're not seeing anything currently. You might see like a blip every once in a while. So I'm just going to start adding some text here, maybe some headings just to prove that this is refreshing. So perhaps I'll just write test and I'll put this within a H1 tag and I'll save this. You can see that it just popped up. I don't even have to refresh the page. And I'm just copying and pasting this and saving it. And you know, it's refreshing every 3 seconds or so. So yeah, that's what you can do to have a web page refresh. You just use this attribute, set it to refresh, and then set the amount of seconds that you want this web page to refresh after these many seconds. Please do not put 3 here. Pick a higher number because that's going to be really annoying if your web page refreshes every 3 seconds, but it works just for this demonstration. So that's the basics of metadata. It's information about data. There's still way more meta tag attributes that are out there, but these are a few of the basics, just enough to get you started. And that is how meta tags work in HTML. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.